Now, we've seen the interface configuration utility a little earlier in that long, long demo that showed you from beginning to end every single step in creating an interface. Anyway, that was kind of going through as fast as I could to get through all the steps without really spending a lot of time on any one step. So now we're going to start going into these things in much more detail. And so the first topic is interface configuration utility, the first step for, you know, setting up an interface. So let me just explain what this is. Of course, interface configuration utility, as you may have seen already, it's for easily configuring and maintaining interfaces without having to know a lot about how that interface startup script works. See, we're actually storing these switches, these startup switches that are associated with each interface. We actually store those in two different places. We store them first in the module database. This is the PI module database on the server. And then we also store this information in a batch file that's associated with that interface. So if you take a look at this OPC interface, the opcint1.bat, that's where we're storing the configuration parameters you see right here. We're storing it there. And as I said, if we switch over to our home node here, if I go into the module database, you'll find it's in a reserved section of the module database that's reserved just for OSI stuff. Under interfaces, there it is. There's opcint, and here are some of the, you know, all the different switches, like for example the different scan classes. Remember, we can configure our own scan classes toward the end there, 30 second with a 0 second offset. Anyway, so that's where we store it in the module database. That's not terribly pertinent to this discussion. I just wanted to tell you that's where we're storing it, just to be thorough here. So we store that there, and we typically ask you not to touch anything in the module database under %OSI. Now back to this interface configuration utility. It's used for managing what is in this startup batch file. Now this is a batch file that if you never ever modify it using interface configuration utility, you could do all this yourself. But as we warn you at the very top of this, once you start editing it using ICU, we suggest you don't ever edit it manually at that point. Now, the interface configuration utility is normally located on the same computer that's running the interface. I shouldn't say normally located, it's always located on that same computer. Sometimes people try to configure an interface remotely by, you know, like specifying locations using UNC references. It kind of looks like it worked, but it just does not work. So don't ever try configuring ICU remotely. You have to put ICU on the machine that's running the interface. Okay. Now, it's going to be doing a variety of things in addition to setting up those startup files, those startup switches. This is also where you can go to configure buffering. Okay. This is where you would go to create any monitoring tags. There are some tags that you can create. It's under here called the IO rate tags and the interface status tags. These are things that you can do with interface configuration utility. Create tags that will monitor the performance of the interface. Okay. This is where you can install the interface to run as a service if it's not already running as a service through this service tab here. It's where you can set up dependencies. This is also where you can find the log files associated with this local interface and other interfaces that are local. Okay. It's where you can also create new instances of an interface. If you have an interface that's running and you want to create a second instance of it, you can actually create that and generate this to run as a service, a second copy of the interface running at the same time. Now, I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate how to create a new instance of an interface and associate that with interface configuration utility. I'll choose interface, and then I have a choice of how I create a new interface. I can either do it from a batch file or from an executable. Now, I like using the batch file simply because historically that's kind of where we started with this. We suggested you open the batch file. Each of our interfaces does have a batch file that ships with the interface. And what I'm going to do here is add a copy of the random interface. See, this random interface ships with random.bat, and it's where we configure such things as what the default point source should be for that interface. Now, just in passing, I want to point out that it's very unusual to do what I'm doing right now, put the random interface on a second node, on an interface node, and use it remotely. And I'm not even going to go all the way through. You know, typically, the random interface is just something we keep on the server for generating data for training or simulations of one type or another for your own personal use. I'm just using this because I've already used the one interface that we're using for real, that OPC interface. I've already done that on this node. And I don't want to give you the impression, I don't want to go do this over on the Pi server, because I don't want to give you the impression that you use ICU on the server a lot. Typically, ICU is going to be used on the interface node. So, having said that, let's go ahead and just for the sake of demonstrating how to do it, let's go ahead and set up an instance of the random interface being managed by ICU on this remote node. So I would choose interface, I'll choose new from a batch file. And as you can see, we go out, we interrogate where the interfaces directory is, we find it. I'm going to find random, I'll choose this batch file. And the first thing it's doing here is it's checking to see if the server in the batch file matches any server that's in the known servers table. And if it doesn't, well, you can choose one of two things. You can either add the server, or you can substitute what's in the batch file for this right here, your actual server. And I'm going to choose to do that. That's typically what you would do. And here we have it. This is an interface that's been identified as the random interface. This is the type of interface it is. It's taking the default point source of R, and it's got the default scan classes that we normally associate with this random interface. So at this point, if it hasn't already saved automatically, I can go ahead and save it, and then I can start managing this interface from here. So there we go. I can go ahead and add new scan classes if I want, and do all the other things I would do to manage this interface. Now, I did this by creating an interface from the batch file. Let's take a look at what we would do if we wanted to choose that other option, which is to do a new interface from the executable. Now, from the executable, you're going to notice a couple of the standard things are not going to be done by default. We don't pull in the point source, for example, because we don't know what that is. But what I'll do is I'll go ahead and I choose new executable. I'm going to browse again through the interfaces directory. This time I'm going to go to this interface here. This is another one of our simulators, the ramp soak simulator. We'll find that executable. And at this point, we need to specify what the home node is, or what the Pi server we're sending this data to is, because there is no batch file. We don't know what the default is. It's not been specified. Now, at this point, we can go ahead and specify other things, like what should the name be displayed as, what should the point source be, interface ID. We'll talk about more about these things later on. But I'm just going to go ahead and add this without those things. Yeah, it says we're being reckless here. I haven't specified a point source. So yeah, I'll go ahead and specify it. And now, having done all that, now we're ready to go ahead and configure this interface. And I guess the first thing I should do is actually put in a point source. Yeah, the point source is 9. That's the default point source for that interface. Yeah. So this is now an interface that's been defined using that executable instead of the batch file. I'll go ahead and save it. I'm going to need to create some scan classes. I need to specify an interface ID. It depends on the interface configuration. As you can see, this is truly a brand new one. Without that batch file, we don't pick up any existing scan classes. Now again, just a reminder, this last two interfaces that we configured, the random and the ramp soak, these are just for demonstration purposes. I wanted to show you what it was like starting a new interface, managing an interface by loading a batch file versus just, you know, pointing to the executable. For the rest of our videos, we're going to be concentrating on this OPC interface.